Hi guys, it is a beautiful but windy day here in Paradise in St. Croix, Virgin Islands. Somehow, don't ask me how, we have made it another day on the planet. We have stumbled into Tuesday morning, March 29th, 2016. So Tuesday is when I'm supposed to bring you my wacky conspiracy rant of the week, where I go on the pages, well, in this case, the alternative media to Alternet.org to look at the latest wacky conspiracy theories. Now, this story, guys, I don't know which rant it belongs to. Does it belong in my Tuesday conspiracy theory rant? Does it belong in my Wednesday climate change rant? Or does it belong in my Saturday Clueless Moron rant? And actually, that is the first place this is turned up, and this is this whole notion of cloud seeding. I noticed in today's mainstream media, right here on the top 100 news stories, talking about how drought hit Thailand sends up the Royal Rainmakers. The Royal Rainmakers. It's called cloud seeding. Now, I mentioned it in my Clueless Moron Roundup rant a couple of weeks ago in the mainstream media. They were talking about Los Angeles County. Los Angeles County actually seeding the clouds of one of these big El Nino storms that was coming in to Southern California anyway. I believe it was on March 13th, seeing this big ass storm rolling in, bringing the rain that everyone's been praying for. But what do? They were sending up their planes to actually make the existing rain cloud even rain more. So that got a mention in my Clueless Moron Roundup rant. And after reading this story here in Alternet, this long involved story, why Southern California's new cloud seeding project has conspiracy theorists in a frenzy. You know, this is one of these cloud seeding. It's where I just feel like I am just completely surrounded by clueless morons to the right of me, conspiracy wackos to the left of me. It seems to me like everybody has lost their goddamn minds here. Right when I was leaving Southern California back in November, without any cloud seeding, they were having in Southern California these big ass mudslides and shit. It was one Mother Nature thunderstorm at the beginning of El Nino. Didn't it like shut down the grapevine for a couple of weeks? I think I-5 was shut down. Hell, back in July, as I recall, in July, in the middle of the biggest drought in years, this one rainstorm in Southern California on I-10, where it rained for about 2 or 3 hours, and this goddamn bridge on Interstate 10 collapsed in Southern California. And I'm thinking, yeah, that's what they need. Yes, California does need some rain. No one's arguing that. They need some rain. But the question is, do they need big-ass, deluge, severe rains? Is that the highest and best way to cure a drought? So I'm looking at the crazy whack job techno utopians poking a rattlesnake by trying to ramp up the severity of a thunderstorm that Mother Nature was already sending to Southern California without some help from Los Angeles County, hiring some goddamn mad scientist to go up there and be spraying chemicals above the skies of LA. And then, so what do you have on the other side? When you take a wild guess, is the goddamn chemtrail wackos who do not understand the difference between cloud seeding and chemtrails. Their ability of discernment and critical thinking is just, it's just, you know, these goddamn chemtrail wackos, and I used to be one, is the most embarrassing thing about this, is they just take the tiniest little kernel of truth, which in this case, cloud seeding, which was even advertised in the local paper that they were going to do it, which you better believe the goddamn chemtrail wackos, that really sent them out on steroids. And then you've got the people, including one person whose name, who's in hearing distance with me, denying that there are still people to this day denying that weather modification is not happening here and now on the planet. Is there anybody, if you are suffering some delusion that weather modification and cloud seeding are not happening all over this planet today and haven't been happening for 50 years, let me dispense with you fucking clueless morons right now. But to take cloud seeding and conflate it in your little conspiracy wacko mind to from cloud seeding to chemtrails. You know, you can go on, there's plenty of YouTubes with them going around cloud seeding, okay? And it's this, whatever their little chemical of choice, I've heard everything, it's usually silver iodide. I've heard in this one in Thailand, they're just using plain old table salt. Sodium chloride is what they're spraying out. I've heard potassium chloride, dry ice. You know, it's not a chemtrail. It's not even a persistent contrail. You clueless moron wackos. Look at the goddamn videos. Spewing out silver iodide or table salt out of the back of some little, basically a crop dusting airplane, is not on any level, any form, a fucking chemtrail. Now, it is being chemicals sprayed out of the back of an airplane. You can't argue with that, although, as I say, there's still clueless morons believing that that's not happening. And so here I am in the middle, and a few other people going, well, you don't have to be a chemtrail wacko just to understand that maybe, A, you don't want to turn a thunderstorm into a deluge, taking out Grapevine Hill on one level, but it just, I don't know, guys. It's just the eco-Nazi in me that just has a problem with spraying, I don't give a shit what it is, spraying salt like they're doing over there in Thailand. This spraying salt out of the back of an airplane, that's really going to do your garden wonders. It'll start raining salt water. You know, the world's gone goddamn crazy. Just spraying this shit out of the back of airplanes, hoping it'll make it rain, and that's one aspect of this article is towards the end is talking about how the shit doesn't work most of the time. You know, the trade-off we're making on it's basically a prayer for rain. Just literally on steroids, I guess. Anyway, guys, this is an excellent long involved article from Alternet's Environment, looking at all aspects of this. I will put the link to this excellent article on here. And encourage you, if you do consider yourself not to be a clueless moron, or whether or not you're a chemtrail wacko, there's a lot of information on here. I encourage you to read this. I'm just going to touch on some of it. Anyone who wants to sit around listening to your old eco-Nazis spin on this article are welcome to sit around, although you should just read it yourself. Anyway, okay, let's look at this article. Why Southern California's new cloud seeding project has conspiracy theorists in a frenzy. 5 years into a crippling drought, Los Angeles County is trying to make it rain. Skeptics believe something more nefarious is going on. It doesn't have to be more nefarious. Just the cloud seeding with silver iodide is nefarious enough. Okay? It's just your degree of nefariousness at this point. I think squirting silver iodide out of the back of an airplane, dumping it on the citizens of Los Angeles County, is quite nefarious enough without being a goddamn chemtrail wacko. Okay. California got a brief respite from its historic drought thanks to a recent wave of storms that swept across the West Coast, blah, blah, blah. But grateful residents don't just have El Nino to thank. Part of the rainfall was, in fact, man-made. But there are some who believe something more sinister may be afoot. Okay, so now suffering through its fifth year of a crippling drought, the Golden State was done waiting for Mother Nature to do her thing. So officials and scientists took matters into their own hands. And I could go off onto a whole other rant about geoengineering, about the inevitability of chemtrails, because you know just give it a rest for a few years, guys, and then you chemtrail wackos can come back out and I'll be out there with you, as you are going to see, and you can take this to the goddamn bank. Officials and scientists getting together, taking matters into their own hands to fight global warming. All right, but that's a whole nother rant for another day. But this is just this is what this looks like in 2016. Okay, so done waiting for Mother Nature to do her thing. So officials and scientists took matters into their own hands and revived an old cloud seeding program to boost the region's rainfall levels. In January, this was the Los Angeles County Department of Public Works awarded a $500,000 one-year contract to North American Weather Consultants, a Utah-based cloud seeding company that's been working for going back to 1961 seeding clouds. And so this is kind of weird, but this particular operation, this will really get the Chemtrail Wackos panties in a wad. It wasn't even done from airplanes. On the night of March 13th, this firm, this Utah-based cloud seeding company, did not take their planes to the sky. The firm switched on 10 cloud seeding ground stations strategically positioned across the mountainous area of northern Los Angeles. The stations targeted cloud formations above Angeles National Forest, where rain would feed into rivers, blah, blah, blah. So this wasn't even done by airplanes. This is by these very evil looking things. Good God, I could start sounding like a conspiracy wacko with all of these just bizarre looking fucking towers full of all of these weird looking things sticking off of them. Well, 10 of these towers right there in LA County are somehow, I guess, firing these chemicals up into the air from these towers. This is your tax dollars at work. Science fiction minus the fiction. Like so much of modern science, the idea of controlling the weather started in the realm of fiction. But cloud seeding today actually comes with a lot of science behind it. And it actually goes as far back as 1946. Cloud seeding is actually quite simple. Particles of silver iodide, or sometimes potassium iodide, liquid propane, or solid carbon dioxide in the form of dry ice, or as I say in Thailand today, this plain old table salt, are sprayed into a saturated cloud to kickstart cloud condensation, a natural process. Once the particles gain enough weight, they fall from the clouds, melt and turn into rain. So this is one of these myths going on, that they don't cloud seed a cloudless sky. You have to have some cloud there to even start with. So, you know, guys, if you think this is going to work in Tucson, Arizona, probably out of luck here. I love this diagram from Wikipedia. Cloud seeding can be done by ground generators, as the case in Southern California, plane or rocket. But so then they get into the cloud seeding, chemtrails, and conspiracy theories. And here we go. Cloud seedings shift from private research to national defense helped fuel conspiracy theories that zeroed in on aircraft contrails, a product of water vapor condensing and freezing around the small particles present in an aircraft's exhaust. These contrails, conspiracy theories argue, are actually chemtrails that indicate the military or some other government organization is spraying chemical or biological agents at a high altitude for some mysterious top secret reason. And then they trot out this, and you will hear this all the time. This goddamn, their smoking gun, a 1996 research paper from the U.S. Air Force titled "Weather as a Force Multiplier Owning the Weather in 2025. So they actually quote that. So persistent is the chemtrail theory now that U.S. government agencies regularly receive calls from irate citizens demanding an explanation. Proponents of the chemtrail theory say, this used to be my theory, that it is an attempt to control global warming. It is not now. But my guess, I was saying in the next 20 years, I would say in the next 5 years, chemtrails will be very real in an attempt to control global warming, while some others cite far more sinister goals, such as population control. I wish, how many rants have I had, if they can figure out a way to sterilize the goddamn human race by putting that shit in the chemtrails, bring out the chemtrails. Start spraying that shit all over this planet. And then, of course, military weapons testing. I've had rants about this. Anyone who doesn't believe that the U.S. military is using some form of chemtrail as military testing got one thing to tell you. It is open and shut case that a tiny few of these quote chemtrails are in fact being this stuff called military chaff, which the main ingredient of those tiny few chemtrails does have a lot of aluminum in it, but it is not these persistent contrails. It is two separate animals. And then this is from one of these chemtrail debunking sites, Dennis Masuro, kind of my point here. Chemtrail conspiracy theorists use cloud seeding as irrefutable proof that all of their theories are valid. Because, look, they're doing it here in the cloud seeding, so obviously they're doing it everywhere and with other chemicals too. That is a huge logical fallacy, but it is their main fallback and argument, so they stick to it until the bitter end. And, of course, then they quote this airline pilot laughing off chemtrails, and then they spend a lot of time talking about this little classified ad in the Pasadena Star News, where the Los Angeles Department of Public Works actually helped stoke the conspiracy fire in late January when it decided to notify local residents about the upcoming cloud seeding equipment by taking out a classified ad in the Pasadena Star News. And you better believe the chemtrail wackos went crazy. And on March 12th, this is the day before they actually did this, the conspiracy website Wake Up World published a blog post claiming the American government quietly admitted to engaging in weather modification activities in a notice buried in the classified section of a small California newspaper. It's in the goddamn yellow pages. But I love this. This is a chemtrail wacko talking about people who refuse to believe in chemtrails. Weather modification, geoengineering, and chemtrails, which they're grouping all together. These are all topics that, if brought up in most circles today, would garner the speaker the telltale look that most truthers have become all too familiar with. It is a look talking about people who do not believe in chemtrails or refuse to believe that chemtrails are part of weather modification. It is a look that has been ingrained into all who have opted to cast aside their critical thinking for their comforting daily life. There is a herd mentality that has been established that causes even those on the fence, I guess, about chemtrails to fall in line while surrounded by the docile masses. I absolutely love it. And my favorite chemtrail buddy, who I love dearly, he has actually said this in defending Dutch sense, that if you don't believe in chemtrails, you are abandoning discernment and critical thinking. Guys, it's hopeless, but don't worry. As I say, chemtrail conspiracy wackos will not be clueless morons in a few more years as the real conspiracy building on this planet between mad scientists and authorities, as you better believe that conspiracy will be bringing chemtrails to your skies any year now. And from that point on, it's our choice, and already is, the frying pan or the fire, global warming or geoengineering. But I will save this rant for tomorrow when I bring you my climate change meltdown roundup rant for the week, which, my God, anybody looking at the climate change news in the year 2016, smoke him if you got him. But that is tomorrow's rant. For this rant, bye, guys. Okay, little dog. Wake up. You're getting chemtrailed. Look out. Look out.